our first speaker will be Dr. Paul Robinson. Dr. Robinson is a postdoctoral associate at Rutgers. His research focus is on cognition, rationality, and human origins. The goal of his research is to advance an interdisciplinary understanding of human nature that can be usefully applied in real-world settings such as conflict resolution and deliberative democracy initiatives. So, without further ado, here is Dr. Paul Robeson. He is virtual today, and he will be sharing his screen.
The issue, humans can consciously produce and evaluate explicitly represented, verbalizable reasons to draw a conclusion. So, talking about the evolution of reason, the kind of thing I have in mind is this sort of conscious deliberation, not unconscious inference or anything like that. There's been a recent claim that there's a traditional intellectualist view according to which the value and typical role of reason is to allow the lone thinker to gain knowledge. A number of thinkers say that this is wrong. The way that the Western tradition of philosophy and psychology has been thinking about reason is all wrong. The new theory that's been proposed is known as the argumentative theory. According to this theory, reason evolved in a social context to manipulate others through persuasion. So the function is persuasion, but it's not to get to the truth, it's just to allow you to manipulate other people. And the claim then is that this is going to explain various reasoning biases. The game plan then for this talk is I want to talk a little bit more about the argumentative theory and set out some criticisms. And then at the end, I want to propose an alternative theory, which I'll call the narrative theory, and show some ways in which it might help to interpret some of this empirical work in psychology of reasoning. This will only be a sketch. This is definitely a work in progress. It's a big project. But I wanted to share this material with you because I think it's probably the central project that I'm working on at the moment. So I'd be interested in feedback. Okay, the argumentative theory. So it was first proposed by Dan Sperber, a French cognitive scientist, in his work on the evolution of verbal communication. He argued that there were selective pressures for what he called logico-argumentative module, aimed at persuading others and not being too easily persuaded oneself. And I'll go through the reasoning, but one thing to notice right away is that this is what's known as a theory-driven or top-down approach, from hypothetical selection pressures to postulation about fitness-increasing psychological ability. A lot of times in discussing evolutionary theories of cognition, psychology will be a just-so objection. Typically, that's because you start out with a trait and then you propose that there were certain selection pressures that explain why we have it. This actually goes in the opposite direction. And here's the argument. So verbal communication is often very valuable. It allows us to coordinate.
talking about, you know, the value of an item on its face, all right, or the amount of use that's the sort of language that's used to teach versus to show, right? And so I was sort of struck in that context that there's also, at least in some cases, differences of word use that maybe are not as referential to some other object the way we sometimes experience or are used to. Trying to build that into a narrative or a reasoning story, I mean, maybe my question's, maybe I'm up a wrong tree here, but.
So, I mean, I can't think of anything off the top of my head, but I mean, that seems like a fascinating area to explore, to actually get into the details of the kind of language that you use.
Sure. Yeah. I'll find you a citation.
Thanks.
Alan?
Great talk, Paul. I just wondered if you, in your thoughts about evidence, whether you had considered early development as the source to bear on some of these questions. It's very striking just how early narratives emerge, understanding of narratives, receptivity to narratives, how early you can read little stories with pictures to babies. How early shared pretense emerges, which, very simple, of course, structure in every other way, but nevertheless also has this very advanced core that it's exercising the theory of mind. And anyway, that seems to be the big, short of time. So that's not really sort of a question, but a suggestion.
Thanks. It's the best kind of comment. That's really a great point and something I should think about more. Thank you.
All right. So I think we're going to take a little break.